Promotion does not come from the east, it doesn't come from the west. It comes only from my God. When God promotes you, nobody can stop it. When God lifts you up, nobody can bring you down. When God says it is your time, it is your time. Today is the turning point. Today is the turning point. To your breakthrough. To your breakthrough. To your breakthrough. In the name of Jesus. Let me bow and I want to swallow your baby this year. I decree in the name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus will swallow them. The blood of Jesus will consume them. In the name of Jesus. Every generational curse that is tying you down this morning, I reverse it. I say I reverse it. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You are welcome tonight in the name of Jesus. It has been some time, but I want to assure you that the Lord has something for you tonight. So get ready to be blessed from the Lord in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray tonight that you open the windows of heaven to bless us abundantly in the name of Jesus. Amen. It has been a wonderful time. I want to thank God for this season. I want to thank God for the Ember months that have just started. I want to believe that you are ready to be blessed in the name of Jesus. I want to discuss with you how to overcome the fear of the Ember months, because I know a lot of people are afraid of the Ember months, September, October, November, December. But tonight, if you will listen attentively and you will believe God and you follow the instruction from the Word of God, you have nothing to fear in the name of Jesus. I want us to read together from the book of Revelation chapter 12, starting from verse 10. Revelation chapter 12, starting from verse 10 to verse 12. And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now is salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ. For the accuser of our brethren is cast down, which accused them before our God day and night. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb, and by the word of their testimony, and they loved not their lives unto the death. Verse 12. Therefore rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil is come down unto you, having great wrath, because he knew that he hath but a short time. Hallelujah. Ember month, over the years, you find that there are months that have created fear into the hearts, into the life of the people. But I want to assure you tonight that as a child of God, if you will obey, if you will believe, there is nothing to be afraid of. Sincerely, a lot of people have attached bloodshed into the Ember months, starting from the month of September to December. A lot of people believe that the devil has released his wicked demons into the heart, and that these demons go around to just cause a great havoc, particularly the last few months of the year, the last 4 months of the year. But yes, you might have seen a lot of atrocities committed by the devil. You might have seen a lot of accidents, bloodshed during these months. But I want to assure you that you need not to be afraid. Yes, from the scripture we have read, the Bible says that the devil has been released, has been cast down, and woe to the inhabitant of the heart. But inhabitant of the heart who do not believe in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. If you look at this scripture that we have read in verse 11, you find that the same devil was overcome by the blood of the Lamb. By the blood of the Lamb. You also can use the same weapon. The blood of the Lamb is a weapon that you can use to overcome the devil in all his realm, in all his ramification. The blood of the Lamb signifies sacrifice, signifies the death of Jesus Christ, signifies that Jesus Christ sacrificed himself on the cross of Calvary by shedding his blood. And the blood that he shed was his life. Leviticus 17:11 says, the blood of the animal, the life of the animal is in the blood. So the blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary is the life of Jesus Christ. Let me show you a few things that this blood did, apart from the fact that we are redeemed through the blood. Number one, we were purchased through the blood. Everybody that believes in the name of the Lord Jesus, that have committed his or her life to the Lord Jesus Christ, that has accepted Jesus as his or her Lord, you have been purchased by the blood of Jesus. Look at Acts chapter 20, verse 28. Look at what the scripture says there. Acts chapter 20, verse 28. It says, take heed therefore unto yourselves and to all the flock over which the Holy Ghost has made you overseers, to feed the church of God, which he hath purchased with his own blood. He bought with his own blood. Colossians chapter 1 verse 14. Colossians chapter 1 verse 14. Look at what the scripture also says there. Colossians 1 verse 14. Look at what the scripture says. In whom we have the redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins. We are redeemed through his blood. So the number one thing the blood did for you as an individual is that you were purchased, you were bought over by the blood of Jesus. You were redeemed by the blood of Jesus. So you are not the owner of yourself. Somebody owns you. Somebody purchased you. Somebody bought you. And that person is Jesus Christ through his blood. So because you are not the owner of yourself, the devil has no authority over you. The devil has no power over you. The devil cannot just come into your life and do whatever he wants or he thinks he can do to you, because you are owned by somebody. And the person who owns you will not release you to the devil. You were purchased by the blood of Jesus. And that's one of the reasons why you need not fear the embarment. The Bible has said that, you know, 1,000 will fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Why? Because you were purchased by Jesus through his blood. That's number one reason why you need not fear embarment. Why I don't need to fear embarment? Why we not fear embarment? I was purchased by Jesus Christ. The same Colossians chapter 1 verse 20. Look at what it says. And having made peace through the blood of his cross, by him to reconcile all things unto himself, by him, I say, whether they be things in earth or things in heaven. By that same blood of Jesus, he gave you peace. He gave you peace. He had made peace with you through his blood. So there's nothing that need to bother you. By the blood that is shed on the cross of Calvary, fear is out of the way. You don't need to be afraid. You should believe God, whether you are traveling by air, by road, by sea. Christ has made peace for you through his blood. His blood brings peace for you. The same thing he says in Hebrew. It's good to see Hebrew also. Hebrew chapter 13. Look at Hebrews chapter 13, verse 12. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 12. Because I know a lot of people are afraid of these months. Look at verse 12. Hebrews 13, verse 12. Wherefore Jesus also, that he might sanctify the people with his own blood, suffered without the gate. He suffered so that you will not suffer. He sanctified you through his own blood. And that's why he suffered, so that you will not suffer. All the suffering that the enemy, the devil, has planned for you, Christ took it upon himself, so that you will not suffer. He carried all your body. That's why I say, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. I will give you rest. Christ purchased peace for you. He purchased peace for you. Don't believe whatever anybody says about the embalmment when you are in Christ, when you have been purchased with his blood, when Christ has bought you with his blood, when he has brought peace for you through his blood. Yes, a lot of people will be afraid, a lot of people will not travel, a lot of people will see demon, a lot of people will see evil, but he has said, 1,000 may fall by your side, 10,000 by your right hand, but they shall not come near you, because you were purchased by his blood. You were purchased by his blood. The revelation that we read, look at number three reason why you don't need to bother or to be afraid about the embalmment. Look at verse 11. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. They overcame him. Who did they overcome? The devil. There was war in heaven. If you read this scripture from verse 1, there was war in heaven. The devil fought with the angels. None of them had victory. The angel couldn't overcome him. He couldn't overcome the angel. But one weapon, sure weapon they used to overcome the devil was the blood of the Lamb. Who was the Lamb? It's Jesus Christ. But he was called the Lamb here. He was called the Lamb here. He was not even called Jesus Christ, but we know he's the Lamb. If you go into Exodus chapter 12 from verse 13, when God wanted to deliver the children of Israel from their slavery, over 400 years of slavery, God told them to take a lamb without blemish, which is a similitude, which was looking forth into the lamp of God that will come thereafter, who was Jesus Christ. They took the lamb, they killed the lamb, they used the blood as the lintel, as God instructed them. They put the blood at the lintel of and the doorpost of their houses, and anybody that hid under that blood was delivered, was saved from the angel of death. They played that, you know, went through the land of Egypt and killed all the firstborn. Anybody that stayed under that blood, the blood of the lamb, was saved. Even the Egyptians that stayed under the blood were also saved. God was showing us that there is a greater lamb that will be coming, that will deliver anybody who believes in that blood, anybody who appropriates that blood, anybody that hides himself under that blood will be saved. The children of Israel were delivered from the spirit of death, from the angel of death, by the blood of the Lamb. The scripture tells us in Hebrews 12:24 that the blood of Jesus Christ speaketh greater things, even than the blood of Abel, even than the blood of the Lamb that was used in the land of Egypt. So I want to tell you today that in the book of Revelation, they overcame the angel of death by the blood of the Lamb. The blood of the Lamb signifies death and sacrifice. Christ sacrificed himself. He died in order to sacrifice himself. He died so that you will not die. He died to deliver you from the fear of the embalmment. He died to deliver you from all the wickedness that people see or talk about in the embalmment. Christ offered his blood. If the blood of the Lamb can deliver the children of Israel, how much more the blood of Jesus Christ? They overcame the devil. The devil himself was overcome by the blood of the Lamb. How much more the blood that swallows every other blood? The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus swallows every other blood. Can neutralize every wickedness that comes from the pit of hell. That's again what Jesus Christ did for us. He gave us victory through his blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary. And that is why you don't need to bother about the embalmment. You don't need to struggle about the embalmment. You don't need to be afraid of the embalmment. You don't need to have sleepless nights about the embalmment. If you are covered with the blood of Jesus. Let's look at Psalm 91. Look at what he did for us again in Psalm 91. We read Psalm 91 verse 1. He says, when you dwell in the secret place of the Most High, and you abide under the secret place of the Most High God, you are saved. Psalm 91, look at verse 1. Psalm 91, verse 1. It says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. That's another great thing. In verse 2, he says, I will say to the Lord, he is my refuge, my fortress, my God. In him will I trust. That's another thing he did for us. And that's why I can't be afraid of embalmment. That's why you should not be afraid of embalmment. He said, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I want to tell you today, when you begin to dwell in the secret place of the Most High, when you begin to hide yourself in the blood, when you begin to appropriate the blood of Jesus Christ, when you begin to abide under the shadow of the Almighty, come rain, come sun, come turbulence, come wind, no evil can befall you. No evil. The example in Egypt, when the blood was put at the lintel, shows that no evil can pass through the bloodline. No evil can pass through the bloodline. Even greater evil than the ember months cannot pass through the bloodline. And Psalm 91 has confirmed it. When you begin to learn to dwell in the secret place of the Most High, when you begin to abide under the shadow of the Almighty God, you have nothing to fear. God will become your refuge. He will become your fortress. He will become your protection. It will become your all in all. So, people of God, are you afraid of embalmment? What have you heard about embalmment? What have they told you about the embalmment? What have you experienced in the past about the embalmment? I present to you victory over the embalmment. And this victory comes through the blood of Jesus. It comes through the blood of Jesus. You know, when Christ went on to the cross to die, he said, it is finished. Everything is finished. He has accomplished everything. Your fear comes to an end. Fear of failure comes to an end. Fear of death comes to an end. Fear of spiritual attack comes to an end. Fear of affliction comes to an end. Every fear that you may think you will have comes to an end. Jesus Christ nailed them on the cross of Calvary. So what should I do? What should I do? The first thing you must do today is to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and your Savior. Because, you know, the children's bread will not be given to the dogs. If you accept Jesus, you believe in the work that he did on the cross of Calvary. You accept him as your Lord and Savior. That's number one. Number two, you need to cry for mercy. Ask the Lord to have mercy upon you. Number three, you begin to appropriate the blood of Jesus. Begin to cover yourself with the blood of Jesus. Begin to cover yourself with the blood of Jesus. In your sleep, when you are eating, when you are going out, when you are coming in, as you are boarding your vehicle, your personal vehicle, your taxi, whatever, your bicycle, achaba, whatever you are riding, cover yourself with the blood of Jesus. As you are flying in the air, cover yourself with the blood of Jesus. As you are going on the sea,
cover yourself with the blood of Jesus. I tell you today, people of God, nothing passes through the bloodline. No evil can pass through the bloodline. Because when you begin to learn to dwell in the secret place of the Most High, when you begin to hide in the blood of Jesus, when you begin to abide under the shadow of the Almighty, you are saved. You are saved. I prophesy to your life tonight, this Ember month, you will find favor in the name of Jesus. I say in the name of Jesus, this Ember month will be the best time you have ever lived in your life, in the name of Jesus. As you appropriate the blood of Jesus, as you appropriate the blood of Jesus over your life, over your property, over your family members, I decree upon your life, this will be the best season of your life in the name of Jesus. You will find favor, you will find comfort, you will find help in the name of Jesus. By the authority of the name of Jesus, every negative word that has been spoken against your life concerning this embalmment, I reverse it, I terminate it, I nullify it in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. See yourself drinking the blood of Jesus. By faith, see yourself drinking the blood of Jesus. And as you are drinking that blood of Jesus by faith now, I decree, wherever that blood flows to in your body, in your life, I decree, let every satanic and in your body, satanic manipulation in your body, let them be reversed, let them be canceled. Every blockages in the name of Jesus, and every deadness in your body, as this blood of Jesus flows through your body, I command life, I command restoration, I command quickening upon every deadness in your womb, in your loins, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, they say you have low sperm count, but I decree upon your life today, as the blood of Jesus flows through your loins, I decree, let there be a quickening. In the name of Jesus, they say there's a blockage in your womb. I decree, as the blood of Jesus flows through you now, let the blockages begin to disappear. In the name of Jesus, they say there's fibroid in you. I decree, let the blood of Jesus encounter that fibroid now. Let it begin to strengthen. In the name of Jesus, begin to pass it to your menstrual circle in the name of Jesus, because there is power in the blood of Jesus. I hide you, I soak you in the blood of Jesus. No evil will befall you through this Ember month in the name of Jesus. Victory, 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 victory throughout this Ember month. Your journey is saved, your journey is preserved in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I seal it all with the blood of Jesus over you, over your household members, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We bless the name of the Lord. In Jesus' name we have prayed. I want to invite you to our deliverance meeting. We have a deliverance meeting every Wednesday, 5 p.m. at Better Bible Church. It's number 1 Victory Avenue in Graceland, in Hawaii, just opposite Lions Omo. I'm sure your God is going to bless you. You will hear more. You don't need to be afraid. Your fear is cast away in the name of Jesus. You will see the end of your enemy in Jesus' name. Amen.
We believe you've been richly blessed through this teaching by God's servant, Pastor J.A. Onolapo. And as you apply these kingdom principles, you will be liberated from every satanic power that has tied down your destiny. For he that Jesus has set free is free indeed. Worship with us every Sunday at 7 a.m. first service and 9:30 a.m. second service. Come and experience the power that destroys every satanic yoke in our deliverance school every Wednesday at 5 p.m. And meet with God who answers prayer in our solution hour every Thursday at 5 p.m. Have a date with destiny in our anointing service every first Sunday of the month at 9 a.m. And every first Thursday of the month is our Holy Communion and Breaking of Curses service at 5 p.m. Our Overcomers Day comes up every first day of the month at 6 a.m. at Bethel Bible Church, number 1 Victory Avenue, Graceland, Zaria, Nigeria. For maximum academic performance and excellence, spiritual and good moral training, enroll your child or ward today at Bethel Schools. Application forms are available in daycare, nursery, primary and secondary session at Bethel Schools, number 1 Victory Avenue, Graceland, Zaria, Nigeria. Are you a minister, church leader, church worker, or you aspiring to be one? Enroll in Better Global Bible College for diploma and higher diploma in ministerial studies. We train to attain. God bless you.